discussion of the pectoral region. Here you can palpate, and this notch, it is called the jugular notch, and just above to this sternum, this is the manubrium, and this one is the body of the sternum. This is called the manubrio-sternal joints, and this is the xiphoid point. So just above to the jugular notch, you have to keep the one point. Another point you have to keep over the xiphoid process, and another point which is at the acromion end of the clavicle, to put the incision from the upper end of the jugular notch or upper end of the sternum or manubrium, and at the acromion process. From the xiphoid process, to cross oblique incision around to the breast, and then it goes towards the axilla. This is the second incision, and third incision, which is the straight from upper border of the sternum to the xiphoid process, and third incision, fourth incision from the xiphoid process to the goes directly on the up to the posterior axillary fold. So we reflect the skin. Now you can see this is the anti-axillary fold, which is formed by the pectoralis major muscles. This is the pectoralis major muscles, and above to this pectoralis major muscles, there is a fascia. It is called the pectoral fascia, or it is called the deep fascia. Medially, it continues as a periosteum of the sternum. Above, it is continues as a periosteum of the clavicles. Laterally, it continues as a upper, and laterally, it is continues as a fascia of the deltoid. And below to the anteriorly and inferiorly, below to the pectoralis major, it becomes continuous as a inside the axilla, as a axillary fascia. So this is the pectoral fascia, which covering to the pectoralis major muscles. Medially, it continues as a fascia, which periosteum of the sternum. It is continuous as a periosteum of the sternum. Above, it is continuous as a periosteum of the clavicle. Above and laterally, it is fascia covering to the deltoid, and below and laterally, it covered to the pectoralis major, and then below it become continuous as a axillary fascia. So here you can see this is a cutaneous nerve, vein, artery, and nerves. You can see this three structure: one inside the intercostal space, inside the costal groove, the structure are above to downwards, vein, artery, and nerves. So these are the structure you can see from above to downwards: vein, artery, and nerves. This is the artery, and inside the nerves. These are the another anterior cutaneous nerve, intercostal nerves. This one is the pectoralis major muscles. Here you can see this is the cephalic vein. This one is the deltoid muscles over the shoulders, and this is the pectoralis major. In between the deltoid and pectoralis major, there is a deltopectoral groove which contains the cephalic vein. This is the cephalic vein. On the upper aspect, on the upper border of the clavicles, there is a one oral muscles of the neck. It is called the platysma. This is the very superficial muscles. It is the platysma, which is supplied by the facial nerve, branch of the facial nerve. And just you can see this is the supraclavicular nerve. There are three supraclavicular nerve. This is the lateral group of, this is the intermediate, and inner side there is a medial. So three supraclavicular nerve: medial, intermediate, and lateral supraclavicular nerve. So this is the cephalic vein, which goes pierced inside the deltopectoral groove. It pierces and it open inside the axillary veins. So these are the superficial structure inside the pectoral region, and this is the pectoralis major. On the medial side of the clavicle, it has attached and deltoid, which is attached on the lateral side. In between, this is the clavicle, and below it, this fossa, it is called the infraclavicular fossa between the deltoid and pectoralis major muscles. So this is about to the superficial structure of the pectoral region. We will later on, we will reflect the pectoralis major, and we can see the pectoralis minor and clavipectoral fascia. We will discuss later on.